I was on an equestrian team throughout middle school with about 9 other girls. My coach's name was Deborah, and one of the most awesome things about Deborah was that she'd always take our teams on reward trips or events. Trips included outings such as movies, water park dates, or just barn sleepovers. This particular trip was a trail ride overnight. We were ecstatic as trail overnights were only a summer thing and it was one of the first ones of the year. Basically, a trail overnight was a weekend that we would go on a 3-day-long trail ride. We'd pack a bag or two, meet up on Friday morning at the stable, load up our horses and bags into the 3 trailers, and be on our way. That was exactly how it happened this particular trip. Everything went exactly as it should have, and we set off to a trail near the Sleeping Bear Dunes, as I live in rural Michigan. Things got odd a few hours into the trip. We had all left at about 7 in the morning, so that left us with plenty of daylight to do fun stuff after we got settled into the campsite. Deb had us all saddle up to go along the lakeshore trail. Once everyone was in the saddle, we set off on a narrow, single-file-only trail that wound through some woods and eventually would lead us to an overlook of the beach. I was completely in my zone. My horse, Ares, was not. It was like he and a few other horses were sensing something that nobody else did. But we chalked it up to being in a new place that we had never camped before. Being that Ares was a Mustang, I thought maybe his wild instincts were kicking in after a few years of being domesticated as well. At about 7 o'clock that evening, while Deb and the stable hand Carla cooked up hot dogs and the rest of us had to come back from swimming, I decided to take Ares out for a quick trot and a loop around the campsite in hopes to calm him down. I grabbed my helmet and mounted up, not bothering to grab reins or saddle up, and just tied the lead rope to the other side of his halter. The ride went how I expected it to, with Ares acting up. Although this time his behavior was different. He didn't just seem agitated, he seemed distressed, like something was really scaring him. I looked around and couldn't see a thing. No deer, no bears, no other horseback riders or mountain bikers or anything. I decided to go down a little trail that would wind back up at the campsite after about 5 minutes rather than just going in a loop. This is where it hit the fan. We had been going for about 2 minutes on this little trail when I started feeling funny, like we were being watched. I turned around and nobody was there. At one point of the trail, we came across a big boulder, and this was where Ares stopped completely. No amount of nudging or encouragement budged him. He absolutely refused to go any further. I slid off his back and tried pulling him to no avail. That's when I noticed where his eyes were focused. He wasn't looking at me, but over my shoulder. Slowly, I turned around and saw a tall, dark figure about 50 yards away, maybe less, standing ahead of us on the trail, not moving, even though I'm sure he heard us. I didn't know what to do. Was he a hiker? It was obviously a man, but he had no pack, no bike, nothing. He was holding something in his hand, though. A walking stick, maybe. I didn't want to bother him or go near him as his presence had given me the creeps. I whispered to Ares that we were going back and slowly climbed on. As soon as I was situated and I looked back at the man, though, my heart dropped. The figure had turned towards us, watching. I could tell because I could faintly make out the zipper of his jacket. There was no doubt he had seen and heard us, so there was no point in trying to be subtle. I offered a wave, trying to signal I was out of there and wouldn't be a bother. Ares was more than happy to oblige. When I looked back again, my heart dropped even further and I froze. The figure was getting larger. The man was chasing us, running at full speed. I saw what was in his hand, a machete? It couldn't be, but it sure looked like some kind of weapon. I said Ares' name loudly in fear, and he knew what I wanted. He kicked into overdrive as the man had caught up to about 10 yards away from us. Mustangs are fast, and Ares was no exception. That made hanging on without a saddle a bit difficult, but I somehow knew that if I fell, my life was over. And just my luck, I did fall. Ares had put some distance between us and the man to where I could no longer hear or see him, but it didn't take long for the machete guy to come within hearing range. The man came up over the hill of the trail and spotted me immediately. I knew I was doomed. The man started towards me, and before I could bolt, I heard the thundering sound of hooves speeding in my direction. The man, although I couldn't see his face beneath the hood of his jacket, I could tell he was looking behind me. I turned too and had to dive out of the way. Ares was speeding towards the man in like a freight train. I couldn't believe what I saw. Before the guy could dive out of the way, Ari struck him with full force and trampled him, making the guy yell out in pain. He lay there limply, more than likely a bone or two was broken. Ari's was big for a Mustang, and being hit and run over by any horse isn't going to leave you without injury. Ari's disappeared over the hill for a second, then came back and ran the man over a second time. He stopped long enough for me to scramble onto his back and we sped to the campsite. I told Deb and the rest of the group that we needed to call the police and get the hell out of there. As soon as I told Deb, she had us pack our stuff up and get in the trailer and trucks while she called the police. They didn't take too long to arrive as there were usually some scouting around the area we were in. I told them everything that had happened and that the man may still be laying where we had left him because Ari's had trampled him pretty badly. We didn't stick around long enough to find out, but we learned that the guy I had encountered had previously been arrested for assault with intent to kill. How he had gotten into the woods, I'll never have any clue. I do know that I owe my life to my horse, as I wouldn't be here to tell this story had I not been with him. People say horses are dumb animals, but I think Mustangs are different. I think if Ari's had not been wild before, he wouldn't have been able to recognize the threat. Anyway, that's my story. If there are any fellow riders out there, or even just hikers or mountain bikers, whatever you might do on the trail, I recommend you don't go do it alone.